What's going on, everyone? It's Taylor with Apex Hosting, and today we're going to go over how to use the Skript Minecraft plugin. Skript is an all-in-one plugin that includes everything you might need to manage a server, with the addition of new server commands, functions, GUI menus, and a lot more. So instead of having a plugin for each feature you might want to add, you can have them all in one place. But as the name suggests, with these new additions comes the making of scripts. Don't freak out, because it's actually quite easy to understand, but before we go over just how to do that, let's go over the install process. First, go to Skript on GitHub's website, and then press Releases on the right-hand side of the page, and scroll down and find the desired version of the plugin you want to use. Once you find that, you can press Assets and click the jar option to download the file, and then save this file so you can get to it in just a minute. Next, you're going to want to head into your Apex server panel and stop the server, and then check the version to make sure you're running a plugin compatible version like Paper or Spigot. After that, head into your FTP file access, log in, and then find the plugins folder, and at the top left corner, click upload and drag and drop the script file into the upload area. Once this reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. After that server has been completely restarted, next head into the console area and make sure to set yourself up as a server operator to get full use of the plugin. Now, before we jump in, I just want to say that if there is anything I miss or that you need a bit more help with, you can use the plugin's official documentation, which will probably come in handy if you need some help. As for understanding what scripts are, they are similar to other plugins since they allow players to use new commands or actions in the server. The only difference is that you're not going to continuously download and install files for the features. For example, instead of having to download Essentials X for setting homes, you can create this function yourself in its scripts. The inner workings behind the home command are going to look complicated at first due to the amount of code that you're going to see, but it's actually quite straightforward once you've studied it. For instance, when players enter set after the main command, the argument 1 is set string triggers an action. In our case, the code is going to tell the server to save the character's position as a labeled home. This is easily determined by the set to player's location within the script as a follow-up to the previous string. Essentially, the code is created through sentences with specific placeholders, strings, and values. The more you research scripts for the plugin, the easier it will be to create your own. As for finding them, you're going to locate the default scripts from the plugin through the FTP panel, and there are going to be 9 total ones to choose from commands to text formatting. You can also visit the script category on Spigot to download publicly available scripts to use. Combining this with the example ones in the server might be the best way on learning the coding language yourself. Head into your FTP file access and log in, and then head to Plugins, Script, and then Scripts. Afterwards, you're going to want to enter the Examples folder and find your desired script configuration. And once you find that, you can click the Edit button to the right-hand side to view the contents. Now that you know how to find them, you can attempt to create your own as well. This process involves you creating a new SK file and entering the code in the editor. For this, I recommend copying and pasting the example scripts since they can be used as templates. While you're inside that FTP file access, head towards the scripts directory and in the top left corner, press the new file button. You can name it anything you want, but make sure to end it with SK to make everything work. And then after doing this, you can continue to type or paste your desired code into the editor. Once you're done, you can click the save button and return to the main panel, and then restart the server to start loading the script to see if it works. Owners can also just test out the examples before choosing to create their own. But in order to do this, you're going to have to checkmark the examples folder and then click rename at the top of your FTP panel. All you have to do is delete the prefix and submit the changes and then restart the server to enable the examples. Of course, whether you make your own or you have the examples, you're going to want to test out your scripts. If you notice that nothing works, then you can double check that you've coded the script correctly. This might take some time since you'd have to find the error in order to fix it, but reviewing the plugin's official documentation might be beneficial to resolve any issues. And remember that using a template can be the easiest way to learn how to use the plugin. Now, before we jump into the common issues, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos. If you're unable to locate the script files, make sure you're restarting the server after uploading the plugin so that all of the files can generate. If you're trying to use the example scripts in-game and they're not working, they're most likely still disabled. Remember, you have to rename the -examples folder to just examples for it to become available. Alternatively, you can also move and copy all of the files in the main scripts directory. And of course, if you made custom scripts and they're not working, whether you copied from an example or you made an entirely new one for yourself, remember that the formatting is going to be crucial. If any mistakes or errors are there, then the file is not going to work. The script plugin is definitely more technical than its counterparts, but for good reason, because everything you need can be configured in just one uploaded edition in the server. Like I said, check out that official documentation page for any more formatting help, and as always, I'll see you in the next video.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.